Hello and welcome back to Proactive Investors. Joining me today from Great Southern Copper is Managing Director Sam Garrett. Sam, welcome back to the program. Great to have you here.
Good morning, Alicia. Nice to be here.
Sam, some news out from the Especularita project this week. You're currently exploring at the Victoria prospect where you've just announced some rock chip samples. Some results here like 6.9% copper and 1.85 gram per tonne gold. Tell us about these results.
Thanks, Alicia. Yes, it's a very exciting time for us and our company. This is a fantastic example of what you can achieve with boots on the ground exploration. We are following up at Victoria from our earlier work sampling the float on the Hill of Victoria, where we achieved significant results in high-grade copper and gold mineralization. So it's very pleasing to follow that work up and now to start to see outcropping evidence of these vein-breccia type systems with high-grade copper, as you mentioned, results up to 6.9% copper. But what's also pleasing is that it's not just one of these structures that's mineralized. We're seeing quite a number. And in fact, we define it as a swarm of structures. So a whole sort of anastomosing swarm of structures over quite a large area. So we've still got a bit of work to do to define the full system, and it's partially covered, which is good and bad for us, but it offers more opportunity for us. But yeah, lots of very exciting start to the Victoria program.
And Sam, you updated Proactive on the float sampling program just a couple of weeks ago. Investors can catch up on that news there as well on our website. But can you tell us how those results combined with what you're seeing now at Victoria really are painting the picture of the copper and gold potential here?
Yes, the new results validate our understanding of what we're seeing at Victoria. These structures, as we mentioned, they're sitting on the edge of a batholith, and they're basically telling us that we're in a large system. The system that we're seeing at Victoria is very similar to the one we've previously announced also at Terracita, where we're seeing veins, similar type veins, up to 5 kilometers long. So these are big or potentially big structures. And it's very nice to see that they're carrying the copper and gold. And they're also sitting juxtaposed to the large, we've mentioned it before, the large high sulfidation lithocap, which is attractive to us as a porphyry copper target. So in the big picture, what we're seeing is lots of copper, lots of mineralized structures, and we're finding these things by literally walking on the ground. And doing hands-on exploration, which is exciting. I think if Shakespeare was a geologist, he would definitely be writing sonnets about these rocks.
And Sam, looking at the broader potential here, I mean, Especularita is just one of your copper and gold properties over here in Chile. Tell me, what are your plans within the next few months to really capitalize on this potential?
So our plans are to escalate both these prospects, Victoria and Terracita, over the next 3 to 6 months to drilling stage. So to do that, we'll be conducting more mapping and sampling. We'll be conducting soil sampling and geophysics, such as magnetics, for example. These veins being quartz carbonate veins, they don't have magnetite in them, whereas the surrounding rocks do. So with any luck, these trends will sort of light up, so to speak, and enhance our sort of target capability for the drilling.
Well, we always appreciate getting your insights on what's happening on the ground here, and we look forward to further updates as you get these two prospects ready for drilling. Thanks for your time, Sam.
Thank you, Alicia. Very nice to talk to you.